Hello everybody, welcome to today's session. I am Pradeepta Kumar. So guys, this is the tutorial number 6 of Kubernetes tutorial series. On today's session, we will learn how to create Kubernetes deployments, pods and services using YML. That means we will create a manifest file using YML code, okay, for the deployments. Okay, so that manifest file, you know, you can create using YML code as well as the JSON. But in today's session, we will learn how to create a manifest file using YML. Okay, guys, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now for more videos related to different cloud technology, different DevOps tool, VMware administration, Linux administration, and many more latest technology. So guys, in today's lab session, what we will do? So we will create a manifest file using YML code, okay, to deploy, to create a deployment for HTTPD web server. And the web server will run in a single Docker container within a pod using a Docker image. We will use the Docker image HTTPD, and it should listen on port number 80. Okay. Then second, we'll create a service to expose the pod externally so that external user will be able to access the web server. Then finally, we'll clean up the all the resources whatever we have created. Then we'll, you know, how to clean up, that we'll also learn. Okay, so it's my recommend before watching this video. So, you know, for better understanding, you can watch the, you know, Kubernetes architecture as well as the overview of the Kubernetes. So that video has been uploaded. So you can browse to Kubernetes, you know, playlist, then you can watch also. So guys, before going with the lab sessions, just I want to give overview of the deployment type. And you know, what are the main section of YML file. Okay, so what is deployment? Okay, a deployment represents a single purpose with a group of pods. Okay, when you will create a deployment, okay, so using YML or using kubectl or using the GUI console of Kubernetes. So what it will do? So when you will create a deployment, that time it will create pods, okay, and it will create containers. It will create replica set. That means pod, if you can see the diagram, okay, so outer layer is deployment. Okay, so suppose I created one deployment, so as per my specification, so it will create a replica set. Okay, suppose I have defined my YML code, the replica, my replica count will be 4. So that means the replica, it will create the 4 replica for you. Okay, so suppose I have created that my, you know, pod count will be my, you know, pod count will be 4. So that means in that case also it will create a 4 pod for you. Okay, then also it will create a container. So that means, you know, there will be pod, inside pod there will be container. Okay, so as per your specification, it will create also replica set for the application. Okay, so a single pod can have multiple containers. A single pod can contain one or more containers, depend on the requirement. Okay, then the pods share the same IP and can talk each other using localhost address. Okay, to get access to a deployment with one or many pods, you need a Kubernetes service endpoints. So if anybody, suppose inside the pod, inside one pod is there, then one Docker container is running inside the pod. Suppose my application is running inside the container, right? So if anybody wants to access the application from the outside, so we need to establish a service endpoint. That I will show you in the lab session, how to create a service endpoint for the applications. Okay, then features. What are the features of deployment? Okay, so multiple replica. So is in a single, just you define a, you know, YML code. Okay, so you can create a multiple replica of the same application. Okay, then you can upgrade the application. Suppose currently my application is using Nginx 1.7. okay, so easily I can upgrade to 1.9 as well. Okay, then third thing is the rollback. Okay, if something you know, after deployment, suppose after upgradation something happens to my application, that time also I can roll back to the original one. Okay, then fourth feature is scale up and scale down. So you can increase your replica count Then also you can down or slow replica set. So what is replica set? Replica set is a kind of replica of the same application. So there will be, suppose if there are multiple replica for the high availability, if one replica goes down, then there will be so many replica is there to provide the high availability. So these are the features. Then deployment type. So deployment type is there is four type of deployment types. One is recreate, second is rolling update, third is canary, blue slash green. Okay, so that means there is four deployment types. So in a descriptive manner I will describe in next session. So there will be one session for deployment types. Okay, then the fourth the final we'll discuss about the how we can deploy, how we can create a deployment. So using kubectl command, using manifest file, using Kubernetes dashboard. Okay, using kubectl command, that I have already how to create a deployment using kubectl, that I have already video has been uploaded, you can watch that video. Then second, here I am showing that how to create a deployment using manifest file. The manifest file you can create using YML code or JSON format. So in my case I am using the YML. Then finally I will show you using Kubernetes dashboard how we can create a using GUI also. GUI through the dashboard we can create a deployment also. That I will show you in the next session. Okay, then deployment YML. So how YML code looks like. Okay, so in the Kubernetes deployment one more contains following main specification. So there will be four main specification. There will be API version, kind, metadata and spec. Okay, there is four main section in the YML code. When we'll create a YML code, that time you will better understand. So what is API version? Which version of the Kubernetes API you are using to create this object? Okay, kind, what kind of object you want to create? Metadata, data that helps uniquely identify the object, including name, string, UID. Then the specification, we declare desired state and characteristics of the object. Okay, there is four main section in the YML code. So what is API version? So when you will create a YML code, okay, that time we need to define an API version. So there is three type of API version. One is, first is alpha, beta and stable. So alpha always v1 alpha 1. Okay, so alpha, it might contain bugs, there is no guarantee that it will work in the future. Okay, then beta version, the beta version v1 beta 1, that means beta version will most likely to go into the Kubernetes main API. Okay, that means it is in testing phase and it is already tested. Okay, it is no bug. Okay, that is a beta version. Stable version, that is v1, so you can implement in the the production environment. Then kind, the second specification in the YML code. Okay, so that is kind, what kind of object you want to create. So object may be deployments, services, pods, replica sets, namespaces. Okay, then a third specification is metadata, where we'll define the label name, namespace, okay, etc. Then fourth is specification. Under specification, this is the main sections where we'll define the number of replica you want to create, image name and many more. Okay, so when you will create a YML, that time you will get to know how we are defining. Okay, API version, kind, metadata and spec. So let's go for the lab. So guys, this is my the background color is blue. This is my master node, Kubernetes master node. So I have set up two node cluster. So if I'll give kubectl get nodes, okay, I will get the, so there is node 7, node 8. So node 7 is my master node. So this is my master node, and another, this is node 8, this is my worker node. Okay, so this is I have set up two node cluster only. Okay, so if I'll give kubectl get all hyphen o white. Okay, currently one service is running. Okay, so now we'll create a deployment. Okay, as per our specification. So in some different here I will run this command so that when it will create, so we can monitor. Okay, so watch, currently there is one service. Okay, then now we will proceed with the creation of deployment. Okay, so our first requirement is that will create a deployment for HTTPD web server, and the web server will run in a single Docker container, okay, with a pod using Docker image HTTPD. So we'll use the HTTP one, and it should listen on port 80. So we'll create, I have already created one deployment, cd. So inside okay, there is two deployment, for one for deployment, another for to create a endpoint for the for the particular application, okay. So if I'll go to this YML file, there is two YML file. So for the deployment, we have used kind equal to deployment. So I have already explained that thing, right? So what type of kind I will use? Kind may be deployment, services, pod, replica set. So though I am creating a deployment, so I am defining here kind equal to deployment. Then API version. The second specification is API version. In my case, I am taking the beta version of that. Okay, API version. Then third specification, what is metadata, right? So first is kind, API version. So API version, kind, metadata. So third is metadata, where we will define the label name, namespace. Okay, so if you'll see the YML code, so metadata, right? Name. So what is the name equal to test HTTP? This is the deployment name only. Then fourth is specification. So in specification, what we can define? We can define the number of replica, image name, everything we can. This is the main section. Okay. So if you look at the specification, there is two specification. So one specification is for replica. So I am creating one replica. Okay. So currently I am creating one replica of the application. Okay. Template, metadata, then I am defining one label. I am giving a label to the that particular deployment. So what is the my label name? App and web server. Okay, so I am giving a tag name web as a web server. Okay, then specification, I am creating a container inside a pod. That is why I am using the container name will be test HTTP container. Then image name I am using for the container is HTTPD, and the in this what is the in which port that application will listen in the container, this is port number 80. So this is my YML code. Okay, for the whole to create a deployment. Okay, so what I will do, simply I will run one command, kubectl. So before running, I want to show you one thing. There's currently one services is running, okay, Kubernetes data default service. Okay, so what I will do, as soon as I will run, so it will start creating, okay, kubectl create hyphen f, then the file name is httpd deployed.yml. okay, this is my value. I'll give enter. So it is saying that deployment name test httpd created. So if I'll go to here, so you can see that, so it created one pod for me, okay, because my replica count was one. Okay, that's why it is created one pod for me. Then it created replica set also one, okay, because I had defined the replica set. Then deployment, this is the deployment name, is test HTTP, right? Then it created a test HTTP one, it created one pod for me, one replica set, okay, then deployment, okay. So now it is creating. So after now it is not in ready state, okay. So once it will come to ready state, that after that, okay, now it is saying that one by one running. So status changed here, the replica count I had given one, so desired one, current one, ready one. Then deployment ready, up to date, available, okay. Then pod also ready. So everything now perfectly fine, okay. Now the second what we are going to do, so that deployment done, now we need to the second, as per our last session, what we need to do, we need to create a service to expose the port externally, so that external user will be able to access the web server. Okay, so now we will expose the port, okay, expose the application to the outside world, okay, from the internet everybody will be able to access the application. So what we'll do, so we'll create a YML for the service, okay. So what in this case for the service, the kind equal to kind is service, API version I am taking the v1, So for the API version specification, you can refer, there is in the Kubernetes side, you can get the API version, what type of API version you will use for what kind of kind or what type of Kubernetes version, then you can use that. Then metadata, so I am using that, the service name is test HTTP service specification. So here there is the most important thing. Okay, this is the most important things, because we are exposing the service for the deployment, right? Okay, container has been created. So in this case here, if you can remember, in earlier deployment I had given their label name, right? So here I am using the service service YML file, I am using the selector for that, so that it will map to that particular deployment only. So app colon web server, so it is very important. Okay, it should be same as that earlier deployment. Then type equal to node port, so the type equal to node port means the type may be the node port or cluster IP, or might be load balancer, because in my case there is no load balancer. Okay, so I cannot use, so I am using the node port. Okay, then ports, so this is my port name, that port will be 800 and target port is this, because my container port is 80, right? Then here this is my node port 8080. Okay, so what I will do, I will just run this. Simply I will create a service, kubectl create hyphen f, then the my YML file. So now it will create one service for me. Now it is saying that service has got created. So you can see earlier there was one service, right? So now another service got created. This is node port and cluster IP is this, and so it will generate, because 8080, so it will generate a random port for you. Okay, then you will able to access. So what we will do, so I will give a, because my container is running on the worker node, right? So my worker node, what is my worker node IP? Hostname hyphen I. So this is my IP. So what I will do, I will go to browser, control V, then what will my port number I need to give? 31690. Okay, 31690. 31690. Sorry. Colon 31690. Okay, enter. See, now it is the, because my container is HTTP container, so it's kind of the default, they have created some index space, it works. Okay, so now from the outside we are able to access the container. Okay, because we created a endpoint for the particular application. Okay, so now when you will create a deployment overall, what we will do, it will create a pod for you, it will create a replica set as per your specification, it will create a service as well. So in YML, so in my case I have created two YML, so you can put both the things in YML, okay? So that means deployment service can, in one YML file you can put both the things. Okay, in my case I have segregated, for your understanding I have segregated. Okay, so now it's the time to our final is, what I will do, we'll clean up the deployment. So what, how we will create, it's pretty easy. Okay, so first we'll delete. So simply we'll delete the service. So simply instead of create, we'll give the delete, then hyphen f. So now deleted. So you can see, you will not get, there is one service only. Okay, after creation of deletion of service, now I will delete the deployment. So instead of this is delete, it's deleted. Now you can see only one service. Okay, it's pretty easy. So that's why you used to create a deployment using the YML. Okay, instead of kubectl, because in kubectl we have to use one command. So instead of using one command, so in a YML format we will define everything, then we will create a deployment. So it is pretty easy. So in the next videos, I will show you, you know, we'll play more with the Kubernetes. So please stay tuned for next videos. Thank you very much. Have a good day.